Theresa May Keane.
Yes.
Yes. I will love and honour you.
I will love and honour you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
To effect commanding voice. That was about the time Nathan used to stop saying to you, you was born in a pentagram.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a Woolly Hat wedding.
When I first found out that Lauren was meeting a 25-year-old heavily tattooed, bearded metal head. Well, you can imagine the teeth and fists and buttocks clenching and proper. But I mean, when I first met you, Brad, I must say, especially after knowing you for 3 years, I can say that you are the polar opposite of the image that description brings forth. You truly are. And I thank you to be genuinely honest and amiable. And I'd like to say, Andy, Karen, that he is a genuine credit to you. He truly is. I've got. No. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please join me in raising your glasses in a toast to the newly wedded couple, Lauren and Brad.
Lauren and Brad.
Have a long and loving marriage. I'll now hand you over to the new groom.
Go on, Brad.
Thank you, Si, for those lovely, kind words, and thanks to all of you for coming today. It means so much to both myself and Lauren for being able to share our special day with you all. You guys always made me feel welcome to the point of moving with you all. If anyone needs a place to live, it needs to be for the game. I'd like to also thank them both for raising such a beautiful, kind and caring daughter. You both have done yourselves really proud. There are two amazing people in this room, and they are my parents. Thank you for everything you've ever done for me. Thank you to introduce me to the greatest genre of the music the world has to offer. And to also a cup of tea. But seriously, thank you. I may have made some life choices you might not have agreed upon, but you guys have all supported me. Even if you said I shouldn't get so heavy tone, I did listen. But so for both of you and show the other ear. I'd like to also thank my stepmother, Annie. You're someone I call a second mother, and I can always go to you for advice, and you won't judge me for what I do in life. I always enjoy our deep chats we have with Wilkham to see. So if you could all raise your mugs and glasses, I'd like to raise a toast for all parents. I'd like to also thank the lovely bridesmaids, Amy, Molly, Lydia, Dina and Alice. I think you guys have had it way too easy, as Lauren isn't really the person to constantly hash you about the wedding, and would rather be in bed, either asleep or watching Star Wars. What I do know is that if Lauren was a stereotypical bride, then you would be there for her. So I'd like to raise a toast to bridesmaids. I'd like to also thank my best men and groomsmen, Jamie, Dave, Lee, Nathan, Tom. These are people I view very highly in life. Each one of them is unique and make life worth living. When I'm with them, it's like having my own set of comedians. Thanks for all for planning a fantastic stag do. Had a brilliant time with all the boys. One quick thank you before I wrap the speech up. It's to the greatest band in the world that's Avenged Sevenfold. And to also the late Chinese Emperor Shen Nung, who invented what we call today tea. Anyway, right. Lastly, I'd like to thank my darling wife, Lauren. So a long time ago, as you all know, I got the impetus to a band called Avenged Sevenfold. Of course, it was banned, and today wouldn't have even happened. On the 5th of December 2013, I got called on stage to get signed by the band. Little did I know that the person who I married today was in the crowd. A week later, I was being stalked by her on social media.
It's true.
Since the first message she ever sent me, I haven't been able to get out of my head. I now know what the true meaning of love is. Lauren is someone who lets me be me. No matter how much I annoy her with my childish thing, she still loves me. She's someone I can rock out with in the car and not do it. She was someone who always gave me 10 minutes to cut the tea. And she was someone who stands up for me and will be ever supportive me in my life decisions. I know that when life gets hard, she'll be there for me. Lauren is just the most perfect person I've ever asked for. She is the most purest heart, and what you see is what you get. Lauren Theresa May Arnold will always be my heart. So I'd like to raise a toast to my beautiful wife, Lauren. That's the end now.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon, Jamie.
A few of you might already know me. I'm Brad Sims' brother. No, I'm not. I'm not exactly one of them.
I'm one of Brad's younger brothers. Before we go any further, I'd like to make a disclaimer. This is my first ever time doing a best man speech. Probably going to be my last.
Oh, no.
I am absolutely crooked. So, well, and that fact that I'm a friend, so I'm probably never going to be my last. I'm sure I'm going to speak to everyone when I say I'm going to be 14. Brad's dance moves later on. Yeah. 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 Anyone who was there on that stag do will know what I mean. Trust me, you're in for a treat. So, what can I tell you all about Brad? There's a few things you should know about him. He's a sincere person, he'll be there for you if you need him. He's a funny guy, and even if you don't know what's his humour, he'll make you laugh. You'll laugh at him. Finally, the most important thing you should probably know is Brad is a vegan. You probably already knew that. Because as they say, first rule in vegan club is, you do talk about vegan. The second rule in vegan club is, you do talk about vegan. Later this evening, I'll be treated to some more of his favourite vegan food. A full pack of Bourbon biscuits, soy milk and tea. I've got plenty of stories about him.
When we were younger, there was this free of charge acorn delivery service we used to give to people. This was something no one ever asked for or ever wanted. It was back in the day when we used to create some S Club 7 dance routines. And if that does not sound bad enough, we used to perform them for people as well. And there was a time that Brad believed the house had been burgled. Right, I was off school sick. He believed that when he came down those stairs, there was someone in that living room. So he believed he was being robbed by a sniper of all people. Why a sniper rifle? But Brad's choice of defence was a squash rocket. So, what, I don't know what you were planning on doing there, but that's what he chose to do. Let me take you back 12 years. Summer of 2005, when we went on holiday to Sunny Island in Crete. So, for this, Brad would have been about 16 or 17. Dad and he booked us both boat trip to go on. So, we were all looking forward to this, and the night before we spent by the bar drinking, playing some pool. Brad kept on drinking with the help from the local barman, Andreas, who was Brad repeatedly called him Lorenzo. It's not even the same name. It's even almost the same. But yeah. The following day came and we set off. Brad feeling a bit sorry for himself that wasn't quite doing so well on the transfer to the Marine. He gave himself an extra seat in the form of a toilet. Now, what I mean by this is he was a mean, green, throwing up machine. It was not stop. We didn't see him until the end of the journey. So we made it there and we thought it probably wasn't the best idea if he made it onto the boat. But he made it to sea and he was fine. Until we got back on the coach to return, and then it was exactly the same. He was throwing up again, non-stop. But to this day, he claims it wasn't the drink, and it was just food. I was first introduced to Lauren about 3.5 years ago, and since then I've treated her as if she really was my sister. You could say we clinked. Basically, a sibling do, we ram each other up at any opportunity. Although it is pretty one-sided when it's just me and Brad winding around, because she gets really annoyed. And then we just leave it for a few minutes. Still, it's great that we've managed to have that kind of relationship. Going back to how it all began between the bride and the groom, which Lauren met for, who was referred to as a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. This wasn't a typical meeting of two people. There was no eyes locking from across the room. There was no bumping into each other, just an excuse to speak. It wasn't even a romantic setting. Your idea of romance is a heavy metal show. So, to be honest, that's the reason why I think they go so well together. It sets them apart from everybody else. Lauren saw Brad on stage, and she knew she was looking at someone special. Quite literally. Someone special.
I'm hearing what you meant there.
Special needs, bro.
Eventually, contact was made. So, I think it's nice to know that even before they were together, we were passionate about the same things in life, which brings them closer together, which is a really nice thing. As a result, the fact that they've been in the same mindset ever since the beginning, which is great, because you're able to understand it and know it together. Yeah. That happens a lot. Seriously, if you've ever had a text message from Brad, try deciphering some of them. It's like hieroglyphics. I do think that for each other, at the top of my heart, it's the very best for the future. I hope you have a long time together, all the good world. Today marks the first day of Mr. and Mrs. Yarnall. So, Lauren, welcome to the family. Everybody, raise a glass.
for the newlywed couple, to the Arnolds!
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Bradley? For those of you who don't know me, I'm Dave, I'm Brad's cousin. I would like to mention that I am a complete novice of public speaking and I'm very nervous up here. I'm sure you can all tell. First of all, I'd like to say what a wonderful and lovely speeches all yours were. You've left me with a very hard act to follow, so thanks for that. I'd like to thank Brad and Lauren for asking me to be a big part and involved in one of the most important days of their lives. Lauren, I think that you look simply stunning today. Brad and I have been friends for a good 28 years. And I can honestly say he is the kindest, funniest, and definitely the most weirdest bloke that I have ever met. I know Brad is my cousin, but he has been the perfect friend over the years, and it truly is an honour to be one of his best friends. I was so happy when Brad introduced me to Lauren, because I could see how happy she made him. They are a perfect match, and I know they will make each other happy for the rest of their lives. So now it's time for me to tell you a few things you may know or may not know about Brad. Brad takes a very hands-on approach to music. He's recently started bashing the drums. He's quite good at it, but then again, it's half expected as he's had loads of practice bashing his.
Wow!
Brad's a vegan. I tried to think of something funny to say about this, but all I could find was this joke. So why did the tofu cross the road?
Why?
To prove that he wasn't chicken. So anyway, growing up together, I have learned some amazing things from Brad. Every bonfire night, Brad and I used to make Guy Fawkes out of cereal boxes. Brad changed the game one year and made a firework out of toilet roll tubes with nuts. It didn't work, but Brad still comes to my house with toilet roll and nuts. Brad made me one of my first music tapes. Obviously, I thought it was cool because Brad made it for me. I got my mum to play it to me in the car once. Smack my bitch up! I never saw that tape again. But I'm still learning to this day new things, like crazy never before dance moves. Weird and wonderful quotes like, if a spider has all those eyes, yeah, one of them is bound to be lazy. All this and much more makes Brad a very unique person, and I for one wouldn't change a thing about him. I'm so honoured to be standing here as one of your best men. You really are a great person to be around.
Yeah.
As I come to the end of my speech, I would just like Lauren and Brad to look at each other. I'd like to say that everybody here is so happy that you have found each other and you have taken the next step into a long and wonderful life together. And as you sit there gazing into each other's eyes, never forget that statistically you are looking at the person most likely to kill you. Ladies and gentlemen, it's been an honour delivering this speech. Please be upstanding and raise your glasses for the new Mr. and Mrs. Arnold. Thank you.
Henry! and gentlemen, Fens and Bridal Party, come join your private room on the dance floor, please.
Yeah! easy go? Will you let me go? Bismillah, no!
Together now.